It's better. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So yes, so Murphy is apparently present in our session. But so as I said, I want to give you a quick overview of the overall context of QualiCheck, what's already done, and what you can expect in the 2 years from now. So the structure is very simple. And why is there a QualiCheck project? Secondly, what kind of activities are taking place? Very briefly, what are first deliverables of QualiCheck already, what you can consult now or in the next weeks, and what is in preparation. So let's start with why QualiCheck. Let's take a washing machine or a dishwashing machine. I think in this sector, it's very familiar that we have this kind of energy labeling from A, G, and A++. So that has become very familiar. It has been, I think, a major driver for selection for most households for the appliances. Of course, everybody expects that these labels are reliable. And of course, also, you are not only choosing such a device because of the label, you also expect that it's of good quality. And we know there are some differences. You look to the quality of the washing or the dishwashing. You look to the sound level. You may look to the duration of the program and so on. But so basically, you expect a reliable label, that the energy characterization is reliable. And of course, also, you expect that the product is working well. If we now make the comparison to buildings, where you have here, let's say, a relatively basic example of a building, as you know, we have to characterize these buildings by an energy performance certificate. You should expect that this certificate is reliable. And of course, also, you not only expect the building with a reliable certificate, but overall also, let's say, a building of a good quality. And this quality has to do with its basic functions, like, for example, if you have concrete that after 3 years, the concrete stays good. There's an example here of what is not good. And of course, if you think of the energy-related aspects, whether it's insulation or renewables, also you there expect that over time the energy performance is remained, but also that, of course, the overall quality of the work remains and that you don't have, like here in this apartment building, PV systems, which after a heavy storm are not anymore where they should be. So you see also for buildings, the key challenge is guarantee reliability of the EPC, that it really represents the performances, and secondly, that overall you have a good quality. And that basically, I would say, summarizes the two objectives of QualiCheck. So we aim to set up a series of actions which should result in more attention and practical initiatives for actual compliance with the claimed energy performances, as well for new and renovated buildings, or simply set, create the boundary conditions which force people to do what they declare, in that way that the EPC is reliable. And the second key objective is to set up a series of actions which should result in more attention as well as practical initiatives for achieving a better quality of the work, or simply set boundary conditions which stimulate and allow the building sector to deliver good quality of the work. So that's the overall context, the overall objectives. What kinds of activities are then the plans of taking place? Basically, we work in work packages, but in terms of approach, we have the first part, which is, I would say, ending the end of this year, is looking what do we find today in practice, so status of compliance and quality on the ground. That's the first, let's say, element, is to collect good information, whether good examples are bad examples, but to raise awareness, to make people aware, and what are the good points, what are the critical points, so that there is motivation in case there are problems to act. And then we have, let's say, a series of activities which you can put under the umbrella of solutions and basically split up in three kinds of aspects. That's first of all, how can you, let's say, improve easy access of compliant EPC input data? Secondly, actions resulting in better quality of the work. And then thirdly, and that's linked to the two previous ones, how can you come to better compliance and, if needed, effective penalties? So that are the two break blocks. First of all, what the situation today, and then as we expect that there are critical situations, how can you structurally improve the situation? The webinar of today, and in particular the three presentations afterwards, are focusing on the first part. So they present you new studies dealing what is the situation on the ground regarding quality of the works and or compliance with the EPC. Within this overall challenge, which is very broad, we have, let's say, in order to be focused enough, We have two kinds of let's say focus area. First of all, in terms of technology, we are basically focusing on four technology areas without excluding other technologies, but at least for these four, we have a focus that is everything about transmission characteristics, everything regarding ventilation and air tightness, thirdly, sustainable summer comfort techniques, and then finally, renewables in multi-energy systems. So that's the first focus area, as we have specific teams focusing on each of these topics. Secondly, as you know, we have, let's say, a very large number of countries in Europe. It's not evident to have really, I would say, good interaction with all of them. So therefore, we have decided to focus on 9 countries. You see them here marked with the green circle. And the choice of the countries, let's say, is based on different criteria, the size of the country, the fact that they are, let's say, a cold climate or warm climate, let's say also what is the level of progress achieved with respect to EPC compliance and for quality of the work, so that we hope to have a somewhat representative sample of the countries throughout Europe. So that's, let's say, very briefly the kind of activities we are working on. Now, this is translated into deliverables, and I think this is more or less the end of my presentation. So on the one hand, very briefly, what are the first deliverables today that are available, and then finally, what is in preparation. If you want to know what's going on, I would say go to the website, thequalitycheckplatform.eu, where you, let's say, basically find everything which is available, like, for example, at the moment, but this will be the last day, you see the announcement of the webinar of today. But you find that also for the different, I would say, major deliverables information, like what's reports coming out, and what are conferences where QualiCheck is involved, and so on. So that all you find on the website, and all the reports, fact sheets, and so on, newsletters you will find, or you find on the website. By referring to newsletters, this is the next slide. So indeed, we produce twice a year a QualiCheck newsletter, where you get, let's say, a condensed information, what is, let's say, achieved, what is in the planning, new events, as well as some information from different sectors. Then we have already some deliverables close to finished about status of compliance and quality on the ground. So the status today, and there we have a report which is technically finished. And you see here the cover, or let's say the draft cover on the right-hand side. It's technically finished. It's now in the final process for publication, which will be very soon. You see here the table of content. And so this is really focusing on what information is available today, basically, let's say, at the start of the project, and where you find, let's say, for the 9 countries, what's the overall situation at country level. Secondly, you see for the different focus area technologies, examples of observed performances in daily practice. So what are existing studies which give information of where are we today? And then also the last section is examples of potentially interesting schemes, whether existing or whether under development. For example, for chapter 3, the examples you find there, you see here, this is a table of content of this chapter, a whole range of examples, whether it's about transmission, ventilation, renewables or sustainable summer comfort, with some indication, are these examples relevant for, let's say, data collection, for quality of the works, or for the issue of compliance. Just one example of a study which you can find in this report, which will be published in the coming week. So here you see, for example, a study carried out in France before the start of QualiCheck, where about 1,300 new dwellings were evaluated with respect to the quality of ventilation systems, where you see there were more than 1,200 non-compliances or dysfunctions. You see quite a lot of problems with the exhaust airflow, with the air inlet, the air outlet, and so on. So you see quite a lot of let's say, non-compliances. And if you translate that into how many, let's say, buildings you can say have a problematic ventilation system, and you see that for the multifamily dwellings, according to this study, 44% is problematic, and for the single-family dwellings, even 68%. So that's an example of the situation of the ground, which let's indicate that probably more attention is needed regarding the quality of ventilation systems. In the report I just presented, these are all studies, let's say, carried out outside the strict QualiCheck project, but we have also about 10 studies really carried out as part of the QualiCheck project. And so the presentations later on, let's say, are linked to these studies, but that you will hear after my presentation. We have also, in terms of already deliverables, let's say, available reports related, let's say, to providing solutions. And there are two reports which you can download from the website. The left-hand report, it's a draft version. You see that linked to compliant and accessible data. It's, let's say, a first effort. How can you, let's say, come to better approaches? The right-hand side is a similar report, but then focusing on the quality of the work. So both reports are drafts, were relatively quickly finished in the startup phase of the project with the idea that if stakeholders have feedback, we can update it. So towards the end of the year, we plan an update. But already the draft versions you can download from the website. Finally, another deliverable, of which the first one is now available, is called Fact Sheet. It's a relatively condensed document, let's say 4 to 10 pages, whereby specific aspects are presented, can be results of new studies, but can also be interesting national approaches. So this one is about, let's say, the approach used in France with respect to building air tires. You can download this also from the QualiCheck website. So finally, what is in preparation? I think a major element, and it will have different spin-offs, is the production of two source books. And by source book, we mean documents which might give stakeholders, countries, ideas, how can we come to better compliance and or better quality of the works. And of course, each context, national context, is different. So we give more ideas in the sense of, you know, this might work in you, but each country has to do the exercise for himself. So in the case of the source book compliant in relation to EPC, there we try to promote the idea of, let's say, focusing on three different aspects in the process. First of all, try to have procedures which allow you to obtain and prove compliant data. And this in particular means there should be clear procedures what must be done, which today we not always see in all the countries. So once you have this, the second step is you should have robust legal procedures in case of non-compliance. So there should be clear legal procedures how to decide on non-compliance and the related actions. So no discussion about how to act in case of non-compliance. And then the third critical step is, and that is also sometimes missing, in case now you should organize, of course, activities that allow you to detect non-compliance, and then also you should effectively act. So in case of the three steps, if they are, let's say, well implemented, and it can from country to country vary a lot, then you can expect to come to a good EPC. In case that on one of these three aspects you have major shortcomings, the risk is that you will end with a problematic, let's say, reliability of the EPC. So that's what we try to work out in these source books. We will also highlight the importance of society support, which we think is extremely important in the framework of compliance. We want to do a similar report about the quality of the work, but I will not explain because basically it's the same project, but let's say the focus is different. And so what we have in mind is we should have a draft ready for the September conference, which I'll explain to you in a minute. A draft report where then the idea is to present it at this September conference and then about 1 year for interaction with the stakeholders, because clearly we expect a substantial evolution based on the stakeholders' interaction. But so the draft should be ready in September this year. And then we should have the final report, let's say two final source books, at the end of the project, which is March 2017. What is also in the pipeline is a number of additional conferences. We had the first conference in September last year. So the second conference is scheduled this year on September the 4th. We will focus on the one end on the problematic of the second recast of the EPPT, but also this topic of better compliance, quality of the work, and in particular, let's say, the presentation of the draft version of the source book in order to start up the stakeholders' interaction. Another deliverable has to do with focused workshops. As you know, we have these four technology areas, and so for each of them, we plan a workshop. We had already a first workshop in March in Lund, Sweden, 2 days workshop focusing on ventilation and air tightness. And we are now in the preparation phase of the second workshop dealing with sustainable summer comfort, which will be held next year in March in Athens. So at this workshop, which will be 2 days, we will basically, let's say, work around topics as solar control, thermal baths, ventilative cooling, cool roofs, daylighting, as well in relation to the compliance of EPC, as well with respect to the quality of the work. So that's very briefly. There are a number of other deliverables, but that's briefly the kind of key activities we plan. And so I propose to close here my introduction and give the floor to Susanne Geisler, who will present, let's say, recent experience from Austria. Thank you for your attention.